Hi, AT from CNC at home. When I'm using LightBurn for doing coasters, one of the things I like to do is start with a template. Now, doing a template for a coaster is pretty easy. It's a square. It's nothing more than a square that fits the tile. Depending on the project, either 108mm, 109, or sometimes 110mm. It all depends on the project. 109 is kind of the one I do when I'm doing one-offs. It gives me a pretty good representation of the tile. Another project that I've been working on are doing dog tags. So here's the little dog tag blank. It's just a little, basically a rectangle with a hole in it. And I just made a simple template for this. I made two rectangles. I just rounded off the corners for one, and then the other is a rectangle in the middle. I'll show that here in LightBurn in a second to kind of be my working area. I was thinking it'd be nice to have a template for the dog tag that's a little more accurate. And my idea was to get a picture or a scan of a dog tag and get that into LightBurn, do an edge trace on that, turn it into a vector. I thought that would be simple. It'd give me a real clean thing. Let's go into LightBurn and see how that works. This could be used with any object that you're going to need as a template. Either take a picture of it or scan it, bring it into LightBurn, and then make your template from that. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Let's head over to LightBurn and see how that works. Now that we're in LightBurn, I'm just bringing up my template that I used for the coaster real quick and take a look at that one. As we can see, I also have some notes on here. The notes actually are incorrect. This says a 108 by 108 millimeter coaster template. And that is incorrect because I opened up the 109 millimeter template. So I obviously copied that from one to the other. Here it even says that the tile is closer to 109. Interesting. So I'll just go ahead and click OK. The nice thing about this particular feature, project notes, you can put anything in here you want for your project. If you turn on this little checkbox down here, every time you start that project, you'll get these notes coming up. It can really help you out just to remember what you need for a specific project, either materials, settings, that sort of thing. Down here in our corner, I'll zoom in on that. We see just a basic rectangle, actually two rectangles in this case. We'll see an outer one, and that one is our 109 millimeter. And then we see this inner one, which should be the, well, interesting, it's 107.75. I don't remember setting that. Anyway, I did it for a reason, I'm sure. The 109 really represents just over the size of the tile, and this inner one obviously then is a super safe zone that anything in there should be on the tile if the laser is aligned properly. Let's go ahead and just get rid of that. Well, no, we don't want to save that. Let's open up the dog tag template and take a look at that one. Here we have the dog tag down in the lower left. We'll zoom in on that. And this literally is two rectangles. We have the inner rectangle, which is our safe area. We have the outer rectangle, which represents our dog tag. And to get these corners, I just set one of the parameters to, for the rectangle, I wanted rounded corners. And I just increased the rounded corner until it looked about right. I also put a circle over here to represent the hole in the dog tag. And the dimensions of everything are from the dog tag. So when I measured this up, it's 50 millimeters long and 28.9, almost 29 millimeters wide. I measured up this hole and it's about 3.5 millimeters, and its location I also set based off of the measurements I took from my dog tag. This works fine. There's absolutely nothing wrong with this. What I want to go through is how we can make a template from an object where we maybe don't know exactly how to draw it, or we want something more accurate than what I've done with this. Let's just clear this out. and start a new project. What I did was I took one of my dog tag blanks and just set it down, got it in the light just right, and took a picture with my phone. I tried to make it as square as possible so it wasn't skewed, so one side wasn't bigger than the other, the way that it looked. Let's bring that image in, and we'll end up doing an edge trace on that. Here we have the image that I took. It's quite a bit bigger than my working area. If we zoom out, we'll see that. It's just this big, huge thing. What I want to do is just right-click on the image and do trace. Here we can see that it's getting a whole bunch of stuff that we don't need. It is getting my dog tag. It has some artifacts. If we zoom in, we'll see those. We'll be able to clean that up later. I will go ahead and say okay to this. And we have a whole bunch of stuff that we don't need. This is all grouped together. I will first ungroup everything. And then I can get rid of a bunch of this stuff that I don't need. We'll just highlight all of this. Press delete. Grab all of this stuff. Hopefully that's most of it. One way to check is to do a preview. Okay, the preview got just our dog tag, so that means we got all of those extras cleaned out. I do want to clean some of these extras out of the trace that I've done here. I'm just going to put this in the lower corner. Let me do this too. Let me size this. This came in, it says that it's 186 millimeters, and I know it's only 50, so I'm going to set that to 50. And the width came out to be, or the height actually in this case, 28.6, which is really close to what I measured up. Let's go ahead and zoom in on that so we can see it. Now there's a few things in here that aren't quite right, and it's a little crooked, it looks like. So I'm going to go ahead and just select some of these pieces and get them cleaned up because I don't want them in here. Right. Then we'll just select the whole thing and we'll rotate it just a teeny bit. Now that looks a little better. I'll do, here's a little artifact. I want to get rid of that one. Take everything, make sure it's all in the lower left-hand corner. Our size now, just a little off. I'm going to reset that, make sure it's a 50. And there's our template. This is relatively accurate now to what our dog tag actually looks like. This circle isn't quite round, but we know where it is. That's the important part. This gives us a good idea of the absolute or the actual shape of the dog tag. This corner down here didn't turn out quite as well. If I wanted to get really fancy, I could probably take the top part of this and mirror it down on the bottom. That's starting to be way more work than it's worth. I just need to know approximately what area do I have available to work in for a dog tag. Now I have this. I can go ahead and save this and have it available for any time that I want to do a dog tag.
As you can see, that wasn't really too difficult to do. In this particular case, making a dog tag template just by drawing is relatively easy. Two rectangles and a circle. On a more complex shape, this method could come in really handy. As we saw, it's not super exact. It does get us what we need to show us what area we can work in and what areas off of our material. One thing that I tried to look for online was a drawing of a dog tag that matched the size and shape of this dog tag. I thought a drawing would scan in much nicer, and it would have. I just couldn't find one that really matched the dog tags that I purchased. That's why I ended up taking a picture of it. That way I knew it would be more accurate to my dog tag. If you like this video, think about giving it a thumbs up. If you like the content of our channel, think about subscribing. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects. Oops.